Only you, because you're here. Aren't you glad you can say that I belong to Jesus? And so moving on, amen. And then Jesus told Peter and the disciples, I've got to go to Jerusalem. I've got to suffer many things. I'm going to be killed. But thank God, he said, I will be raised on the third day. I'm coming out, but I've got to give my life for the sins of many. If I'm going to have a church, I've got to lay the foundation. If I'm going to have a church, the church will need blood. The church will need power. The church will need faith. The church will need grace. I've got to provide everything the church needs. I got to get everything ready before they come in, because I'm glad today that Jesus is not out somewhere trying to concoct a cure for all of our diseases. He said, I have declared the end from the beginning. He was wounded for our transgression. He's already been bruised for our iniquities. Jesus died and went in the grave. Before he got here, he laid the foundation. He prepared everything. And when he got everything ready, he called us in. He said, come and dine, and dine at the master's table. He said, if you're tired, come on. If you're raggedy, come on. If you're weak, come on. If you're schizophrenic, come on. If you got a hard head, come on. If your neck is stiff, come on anyhow. You say, I am the one that's able to keep your feet from falling and to present you faultless in the name of Jesus. And so, saints of God, I'm enjoying my trip from earth to glory. And it's Jesus in the morning. It's Jesus in the noonday. It's Jesus, Jesus. Can I hear the saints say Jesus? Hallelujah. Jesus is the first and the last. I remember some time ago, I was teaching Bible class at my home in Cincinnati. And I taught this class, and I was teaching the saints about Jesus and Jehovah and what the suffixes, what each of them mean. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Tsidkenu, Jehovah, Jehovah. And I felt good. I felt like I'd done a great job of educating the saints of all of the suffixes that's attached to Jehovah. But when the class was over, one old saint who's dead now and gone to glory, she hobbled up to the pulpit and said, Pastor, lean your ear down here. I've got to ask you a question. I put my ear down. She said, Pastor, I'll never learn all those Jireh. She said, would it be all right if I stick with Jesus? Will it be all right if I stick with Jesus? Yes. If when you say Jesus, you say it all. Open your mouth and say Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus is my all in all. Jesus is the Lamb. Hey, Jesus, hallelujah, was the shepherd of the sheep. It was Jesus that made his way up Golgotha's hill. And the Bible tells me about Jesus, that who for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross. He despised the shame. Listen, child of God, before Jesus went to Calvary, he had something beyond Calvary that was strong enough to get him past Calvary. That was was great enough that he endured the cross and despised the shame. I just come to tell you, you got to have something in your view that's strong enough to get you through the fire, strong enough to get you up out of the valley, strong enough to get you through the test. Ooh, for the joy that was set before him. Jesus had joy. He said, I see myself sitting at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for the saints of God. It made him happy, and he was able to go through the trial. I just come to tell you, you got to have something to take you through the valley, and you'll never serve God until you get some joy. You'll never be able to worship God until you get glad about being here. You'll never please God till you get happy, 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 happy. You'll never be happy without the Holy Ghost. And so, saints of God, that's what makes us tick. Amen. Beyond the cross, I see myself, amen, being raptured. And so Jesus saw himself sitting at the right hand of the Father. Jesus saw himself, amen, after he was persecuted. He saw himself sitting, amen, making intercession. He's sitting there today, right now. If you needed him today, he's available. Aren't you glad you don't have to send for him and wait till he gets here? He's a present help. He's already here. Before you call him, he's already here. He's already made your way. He's already provided your deliverance. And so, saints of God, we've got to pursue, amen, this thing and defeat the powers of the devil. It's the devil that brings division. It's the devil that creates jealousy. It's the devil that brings friction. But today, we're coming to this table, and when we come, there should not be no division, no separation, no friction in the body. We ought to be one people, one, headed in one place, going in the same direction. And so, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, where would we be? What would we be doing? But look at me now. I'm saved. I'm sanctified. I'm Holy Ghost filled. And I'm baptized. And I've got a right to lay claim on heaven. I've got a right to stake my claim. Hallelujah. And so you've got to see to it that your reservation is in place. And so, child of God, Jesus laid the foundation. Yes, he opened up the way. He shed his blood. He gave his life. He died that I might live. And so today, I'm thanking God. I'm giving him glory. I'm telling him I love him. If anybody would save you from a car wreck, or from drowning, or save you from a burning house, I'm sure you would look up and say, I thank you for saving my life. Well, church, it's about time we looked up and thanked him for saving us. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank him. Praise God, Jesus. He did it all. And so that's why we support one another. The saints of God should love one another. The saints of, listen, I don't want to go to heaven without you. I don't want to go in the rapture without you. Come and go with me to my Father's house. And I want you to know we need to pray one for the other. We need to encourage one another. If you're in trouble, I'm in trouble. If you're hurting, I'm hurting. But let me tell you, it's time to give glory and honor to God Almighty. It's time.